We are at the State Capitol building in Hartford, Connecticut, the site of the 2011 America East Men's and Women's Basketball Media Day. All right, we're joined now by Albany head coach Will Brown, who's ready for another year as the Great Danes head coach. And I think there's a lot of excitement for you and your team this year, especially how you guys played last year.
Well, I thought we had a good conference season last year. We really only lose one player that played a lot of minutes for us in Tim Ambrose, who was a good player for us. But, you know, we've got a good group coming back, and this is as impressed as I've been since I've been at Albany in regards to our incoming class. I think we have some guys that are really going to impact our program right from the get-go, and I really like this group. I think we're going to be very good.
How about some of your returning guys? How have they looked so far in the limited time you've had to spend with them?
Well, Mike Black and Logan Aaronhalt are returning third-team all-conference players who I think are ready to take the next step. Luke Devlin was an all-rookie performer for us last year. He had off-season back surgery, but he's feeling great. He's bigger. He's a legit 6'8 now. He's 240 pounds, and I think, again, he's another guy with a year under his belt, having success last year, who's ready to take the next step. And, you know, John Puck started at center for us and averaged a block a game as a true freshman. I think his offensive game is where you'll see the most improvement. I think he's going to be continue to be a force for us defensively as far as clogging the lane, blocking shots and altering shots. And, you know, Ralph Watts is a guy who was our first perimeter sub, really our sixth man last year, who can play the 1, 2, or 3 for us. And I think that this group right now probably has seven legitimate starters. So our biggest weakness last year was depth. We played guys off the bench that, you know, ate up some minutes for us, but we didn't get consistent productivity. This year, I think we're going to be, 10 deep, and our guys that do come off the bench will produce for us statistically.
Because of that depth, will you try to change your style at all? Will you push tempo a little bit? You've always been a defense and rebounding first kind of guy, but sometimes you see depth like that, you can throw some bodies out there and play a little different style.
Yeah, we're going to continue to defend and rebound. You know, that's been our MO since I've been at Albany. I think we are going to open it up more offensively. We did go on an exhibition tour to Canada and played 5 games in August. We played those games without Devlin and Puck, and Black got knocked out with a concussion early in the third game, but we did average 90 points a game. That is a 24-second shot clock over there, but we did play small. We played fast, and we did a whole lot less offensively. We really spread the floor. We set a lot of ball screens, and we attacked. So I think we'll be much more up-tempo offensively, give the guys a lot more freedom to play. But defensively, we're still going to defend. We're still going to rebound. We might pressure a little more defensively than we ever have in the past. But, you know, this is a good group. I'm confident in this group, and I think we have the same opportunity that anybody else in this league has. I think we're going to be good.
The Albany Great Danes opened some great eyes last year and with their great play, and I think people are expecting more of the same this year. I know your expectations are high. What do you think?
I'm very excited about how they look this year. This year they're in very good shape. They look strong. They're healthy, knock on wood. So I know they're coming in with great high spirits and excitement about the season. So if we can keep everybody injury free and stay healthy, I think we'll be an exciting team to watch.
As you take over a program, I know it takes a period of time before the kids get the way you want them to play. How do you think your team responded, even though you were using players that you inherited for the most part? How do they think they responded to your style?
I think great, because I went in trying to empower women, period, and not even talk about the game of basketball, and empower them as people and empower them in the classroom and love them up. That's how I really started it, and I think they believe in me and trust me and love me as a person first, and then I'm their basketball coach. So that's the kind of relationship we have with our team, and so I know that the team concept is, it's their team. It's not my team. It's their team. It's our team. And they really have taken that in. They love that concept.
Who will you be leaning on a little bit this year, expecting them to make that jump to lead you to maybe winning an America East championship?
Well, I think all of them, but I keep repeating to the players that it's our X factor. It's the new kids. Like, our old kids are back, but the new kids, who are those X factors going to be? Because Ebony Henry can't do everything, and Julie Forster can't do everything, because everybody knows that they're our great players. So who are the other players on our team that are going to step up?
Who do you think, as far as you looking at the league, it seems to be wide open. how would you handicap the race going into the season? Because I know it's early and things are on paper, but there seems to be so many returning players like you have for so many teams that you have to be ready for.
Yeah, it's obviously exciting. There's some new coaches too, so there's an X factor. You just never know. And I think it's a great league, great coaches, great players. So I think that anybody has a chance.